Welcome back to 101 Sports. I'm Connor Delpreet.
And I'm Rajat Agrawal. We have a great show for you today, so let's get things started off with the quick hitters.
After 10 games, the Indiana Pacers, led by Paul George, have started the season 9-1 and have the best record in the Eastern Conference ahead of that team down in Miami. Rajat, are the Pacers the best team in the NBA? And if not, which team is?
No. They're not the best team, they're the hottest team. I cannot disagree with that. They're the hottest team, 9-1, but the best team. If you have to ask me what team I want to go out and win a game, the Miami Heat.
No.
Connor, tell me why not.
Because I'm tired of talking about the Miami Heat. I'm tired. We don't have to talk about them anymore. I want to talk about the best team in the NBA.
What, who?
The most balanced team, the most savvy team, the most experienced team, and that's the San Antonio Spurs.
No.
The past three games, their margin of victory is 23 points per game. And this season, they have the least amount of fouls per possession. This team doesn't know how to foul.
Connor.
The defense doesn't foul.
Connor, but they're like 100 years old.
It doesn't matter.
Connor, the Miami Heat, as long as you have the big three intact and you've added pieces such as Rashard Lewis, Greg Oden, and as long as Mario Chalmers is playing his game, they're so much more athletic, so much faster, and they can beat you. They can make up for that lack of depth inside.
But they haven't
by
been
their
doing
speed.
That this year. Their defense has been subpar at best. The Spurs have hit their stride exactly, finishing with the loss last year from the Heat. They look better than last year. They've already hit their stride. They're 9-1. They're one of the most experienced and balanced teams in the NBA.
Can they sustain that?
They
can.
They've done it
every
other year when they make it to the playoffs. Why not this year too?
But you have LeBron James, and that's the end of the discussion right there. You have LeBron James, Dwayne Wade, and Chris Bosh shows up.
You know what? All I have to say is the Spurs aren't a team that are going to get on the top 10 every day for the LeBron James dunks, but they are in the right position every time on both sides of the ball. I think they're the best team in the NBA right now.
Right, we'll have to see. The Deep South is the oldest rivalry. Dates back to 1892. Saturday was the 117th meeting between the two schools and maybe the most exciting to date. Auburn defeated Georgia on a miraculous Hail Mary pass that deflected off two Georgia players into the hands of an Auburn receiver who then scored the game-winning touchdown. Connor, did Auburn deserve to win this game?
Yes, they did. Mm. Let me ask you, did Georgia's quarterback Aaron Murray throw the ball to Ricardo Lewis?
No.
Did Georgia's defense pick up the ball and give it to Ricardo Lewis? No. The quarterback threw the ball to him, and I don't care how many people it hit off hands, they put themselves in a position to win the game. They won the game. They beat them statistically in almost every category. Yeah. Total yards, rushing yards. Turn the ball over. They had more time of possession. They put themselves in a position to win the game, and teams that are good capitalize off opponents' mistakes. Jordan made a mistake, and Auburn capitalized.
That wasn't a mistake. That was just pure luck.
No.
Absolutely pure luck. Okay, Georgia, when they're healthy. This is what I feel. When Georgia is healthy, they're the best team in the country. Now, they haven't been healthy for the good portion of the season, but they had Todd Gurley, they had Aaron Murray. They're both clicking in that fourth quarter, and they set themselves up in a place to win the game at the fourth quarter with 27 seconds
their
left.
Their defense let them down, and Auburn capitalized
on it.
You're forgetting that Nick Marshall and Trey Mason both played fantastic games, and to discredit that by saying that they were lucky to win that game and that they don't deserve it, I don't know about that, Rashad.
Hail Marys are by definition luck, right?
But luck is part of the game. You can't say if a team, did the Bengals deserve to go to overtime versus the Ravens because AJ Green caught the Hail Mary pass? Yes, they executed it. They executed it. Either way, we can't beat a dead horse anymore. It's going down as a win in Auburn's book.
That's true.
That's all. College basketball has finally gotten underway, and the Champions Classic showcased two great matchups between four of the premier teams in the country. Rajat, after watching these games, who do you think deserves the title of best team in the country?
It's tough because it's still really early, but if I had to go right now, the best team today in college basketball is Kansas. You cannot go against Kansas. I think they have the best win against Duke and Jabari Parker, and with that win to their resume, two games into the season, has to put them on the elite level.
Now, I went with a team that is a lot more experienced, in my opinion, and that's Michigan State. First off, they knocked off in the second game of the season a stacked Wildcats team.
That's true.
I mean, that team was ridiculous, and they played a solid game. They have returning seniors Keith Appling and Adrian Payne, who both combined for 26.3 points per game last year. That's the highest guard combo since 2004 that Tom Izzo has ever had.
Yeah.
And then you go past that, and you have Gary Harris, a guy who last year got torched by the Duke Blue Devils in the tournament. And Tom Izzo, after the game, said, "This is not the Gary Harris that I recruited. You haven't seen him yet. This year, he's shown that he is the Gary Harris that Tom Izzo recruited. This year, he's going to make the step up and become an elite player."
Yeah, but that Gary Harris is no Andrew Wiggins that Bill Self recruited. Okay, this guy is the real deal, and he's got help this year. They're all young. That's
true. They're all diaper dandies.
They're all young. But they had 10 turnovers in that Duke game. Only 10 turnovers, 27 of 35 from the free throw line. When it mattered, they showed that in clutch situations, big games, they can get it done.
Oh,
they hold it together.
Game. That's one game.
It's the biggest game of the year.
As the season
and they held it together.
As the season goes along, we'll see the Diaper Dandies aren't really, you know, ready for the big time when it comes to tournament time. I think Michigan State, with their experience, overpowers
right
Kansas
now, I think,
in this situation.
Right now, you got to. We'll see. Right now, I think you got to go Kansas. As sad as it is to hear, there are only 6 weeks remaining in the NFL regular season. With many surprise teams this year emerging as championship contenders, Connor, which teams do you see playing on Super Bowl Sunday?
I see the Broncos and the Seahawks playing. First off, I think we can both agree that the Broncos prove themselves versus the Chiefs that they have the talent to make it to the Super Bowl. And I think they are. Peyton Manning's having one of the best seasons in NFL history for QBs. Von Miller's helped that defense come up to fourth in the league in yards per game allowed. And then I'm going to go over to Seattle, who's quietly sitting pretty at 10-1 in the NFC. They force teams to run the ball when they need first downs.
Yeah,
and when it gets to that cold weather in Seattle, you're going to have to run the ball. The offense hasn't been bad. And if we're going to talk about home field advantage in this situation, because home field advantage plays a huge, huge role. And Seattle, let me read you this.
Right,
they hit a decibel rating of 136.6 at one game.
All right,
Do you want me to compare to what that is?
All right, scream.
That is like
Scream and let me hear it.
That's like standing 100 feet away from a jet engine.
Okay,
they have a jet engine in their stadium, essentially, with the fans.
Have you ever
come
been
on
to the game in the Superdome?
Oh, it's
New
no
Orleans
jet engine.
Saints.
Is it a jet engine? No.
I mean, I've never been there, so I don't know. But listen to this, okay? Drew Brees and the Saints are clicking, and they are really on fire lately. Jimmy Graham, Marquise Colston, and that offense is arguably one of the best offenses in all of NFL.
But the I agree with you
with the Broncos. Peyton Manning, I mean, when you go to Tennessee and you learn those tools, man, can't really beat that.
You can't.
But the New Orleans Saints are the best team in the NFC right now. And I think they're most dangerous because you just can't stop them on offense.
But
yes, their defense is bad.
What happens when they try to run the ball?
It doesn't matter when you can pass it. When you can pass that well, no one can stop you.
Versus the Seahawks first-rated pass defense in Seattle with a jet engine in the stadium? I don't know, Rashad. But either way, it's going to be exciting to see if our predictions are right. Hopefully we can revisit them.
Be good season.
That's all the time we have for this block, but don't go anywhere, because up next, Rajat will be sitting down with our NFL experts to talk some pigskin football. You don't want to miss this.